Requesting all who are in the front seats to please move back. Requesting all who are in the front to please move back, other than the media. Media to stay on the right side. Please clear the area. Kindly clear the area. Requesting to clear the area, please. It's a security announcement. Please clear the area. Please clear the area. May we all take your seats. We'll be starting the program shortly. Can you all please take your seats? Clear the dais area. Thank you. Kindly remain seated. On behalf of Gopio's Biennial Convention held in Bahrain for the year 2018, we'd now do a floral welcome of our respected guests who are on the dais. There's a security announcement that all who are standing near the doors, please clear the doors. Please clear the doors and kindly sit on the chairs. There's a security announcement. Please clear the doors. Please clear the doors. Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. We now start the program with a floral welcome on behalf of Gopio. I now request Nidhi to please hand over the bouquets to be given to the dignitaries. Please put around as we play the national anthems of the Kingdom of Bahrain and our country, India. Kindly remain silent as the national anthem is played. Please remain silent and keep standing as we play the anthems of both Kingdom of Bahrain and India. Your seats. Now I call upon Mr. Soumen
Excellencies, distinguished guests, for the Indian community in Bahrain. Star of India. Who was recently elected as the He is making his first visit outside. Prime Minister's 130-year-old party. And Prime Minister Rajiv Gandhi, who modernized India. Grandson of Mrs. Indira Gandhi, the architect of modern India. Auditorium, or maybe in Bahrain, who had the privilege in 1981. I am really privileged of Bahrain. All in the presence of a few Despite their busy schedule, they are with us here today. And the first person with gratitude is His Excellency Sheikh Khalifa bin Daij Al Khalifa, the Crown Prince. I want to tell you, this event would not have been possible . So the entire Indian community is grateful to you, Your Excellency. Khalifa bin Daij is the recipient of the first along with Dr. Varghese Kurian, Mr. Sunny Gulati, and some other people, other visitors like Dr. B.R. Shetty and our own MLA, Mr. A.B. Eden, and former Chief Secretary of Karnataka, Dr. J. Alexander, former Chief Secretary of Tamil Nadu, Dr. P.C. Siriak, Mr. Jusa Rupavala, and principals of various schools, and priests of various churches, and the many organizations head who are all here. And I am so happy. It is not my duty to speak, and you are all waiting to listen to our dear Rahulji, and wish you all a very, very pleasant evening. Thank you.
For the opening remarks, now I call upon Dr. Thomas Abraham.
Honorable Sri Rahulji, their excellencies, Dr. Shashi Tharoor, Dr. Sam Pitroda, my colleagues, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you to this finale session of the Global Organization of People of Indian Origin. Rahulji, I extend you a very, very warm welcome. In 1983, as a young activist and leader, the president of the local Federation of Indian Associations, I had the great honor and privilege to host your grandma, late Sri Indira Gandhi. When we thought of building a pan-Indian global organization, our first stop was to late Sri Rajiv Gandhi, who was the Prime Minister at that time. He became the honorary patron of our first global convention of people of Indian origin in 1989, which was the beginning of a worldwide movement for Indians. In fact, 14 years later, Government of India under Prime Minister Vajpayee started Pravasi Bharatiya Divas. But Gopio was the beginning. We cooperate with Government of India in all aspects. We are the voice of the community. We are the voice of India and building the image of India in every part of the world. We have worked very hard, but we also take up issues with Government of India. Under Congress government, we took the issue of passport surrender issue. Of course, Manmohanji right away corrected that. We took the issue of demonetization. We still have all the OCI and people of Indian origin who are citizens of other country. We have not been able to deposit our funds, which is worth about 10,000 crores, still lying with our people. We have appealed to the government. It has not taken up, and we hope that some resolution will come on that. We have continued to take the issue of rehabilitation of NRIs, returning NRIs to India. So we are a voice for India, every part. But I also wanted to mention to you that the 30 million people of Indian origin, if you consider us a nation in a network world, we are bigger than many of the advanced countries of Europe in terms of our assets, in terms of our income, in terms of our technological edge. And we call upon the government of India to come and utilize our talents, our technological edge for the development of India, and not only for development of India, but the global development. Finally, 200 years back, the most influential diaspora was the British diaspora. About 50 years back, it was the Jewish diaspora. About 20 years back, it was Chinese. And we are emerging as the most dynamic and influential diaspora right now. And we hope, we want to work with you, the leaders of India, for India's development and global development. Thank you. May I invite Mr. Sunny Kulathakal, our convener, our incoming president, who will be taking over tomorrow as a president, to give his welcome.
Respected Sri Rahul Ji, Your Excellency Sheikh Khalifa bin Zayed Al Khalifa, Other Excellencies and ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Salam alaikum. Namaskar. This is a historical day for Pravasis. As Mr. Soman Baby mentioned, we have in our midst the great grandson of a great grandfather of a great nation. We left the shores of India, but India has not left us. That is why Sri Rahul Gandhi, the Congress President, is with us today. This is his first overseas visit after taking over as the President of AICC. For India, a defining moment in its unstoppable journey to a new era was started by Rahulji's great-grandfather, Jawaharlal Nehru, who represents the soul of India. India reaped what it has sowed through hard work, education, and the wisdom of its elders like Rahulji's great-grandfather, who built IITs and other educational institutions in India as early as 60s. Louis Pasteur said it long ago, fortune favors the prepared mind. I had the rare opportunity to see Sri Jawaharlal Nehru at the age of 6 when he visited Kerala during 1950. I traveled 15 kilometers by bus without the permission of my parents and school authorities, and I saw him at a distance. During the 80s, when Mrs. Gandhi visited Dubai, I was in charge of her media coverage. I got the opportunity to meet and discuss with Mr. Rahul Gandhi several problems of NRIs. You can take an Indian out of India, but you cannot take the Indianness out of it. People outside India are more Indians than people inside India. The destiny of India's diaspora in many ways is intertwined inextricably with India. What Gopio thinks today, government of India does tomorrow. For the past 3 decades, Gopio gave several proposals to the government of India, and most of those were implemented. Notably among them are PIO cards, overseas Indian citizenship, Ministry of Overseas Indian Affairs, and many other actions were the result of Gopio's continuous representation. Rahulji, you are a magnet to inspire the young generation and galvanize bilateral relations. Gopio represents the largest vibrant Indian diaspora. Gopio's future endeavors will further the bridges, the friendship between India and their adopted countries. The world knows India through the expatriates worldwide, and the Indian diaspora is a model of tolerance, loyalty, and trust. The world knows that we are extremely happy that Rahulji recognized the importance of expatriates. We look forward to your continuous support, and as said earlier, we at Gopio will extend our full cooperation and participation to make India greater. In the Gopio Global Convention, and it is my privilege to welcome you to address the gathering.
Ladies and gentlemen, next is what we all have been waiting for, the keynote speech by Sri Rahul Gandhi, President of the Indian National Congress.
Your Excellency Sheikh Khalifa, Suman Baby Ji, Dr. Thomas Abraham Ji, Sunny Kulatakal Ji, Neeraj Bakshi Ji, Isaac John Ji, Sam Pitroda Ji, Congress friends, brothers and sisters, I'd like to welcome all of you here today. It's an honor for me to come here. I remember once I was a little boy and I had a chemistry teacher. I had a chemistry teacher who had worked in Bahrain. And she used to keep telling me that one day you must go to Bahrain to see what has been done in Bahrain. And she told me how that as an Indian person in Bahrain, she always felt accepted. She always felt part of the country, and she never felt discriminated against. So I would like to thank the people of Bahrain. But she also said that the Indian community has played a huge role in helping build Bahrain. So it is a joint effort, and it is something that we are very, very proud of. And it is an honor for me to come here and address you in this great country. I'd like to thank the Global Organization of People of Indian Origin, Gopio, for the invitation to speak to all of you. I'm very happy to be here, and I'm excited to talk to you. I've got one little question. Does everybody here know Hindi, or would you like, everybody understands Hindi? Because there's few parts of my speech which are in Hindi, but I want to know if I should make a couple of translations to help the people who don't know Hindi. Anyway, you know, Indian politics, it's quite a strange experience. We've got Shashi Tharoorji here, Sam Pitroda, Haibi Ji. It's a strange experience. You come across many different things. So I'd like to start with a little story. I've been in politics now some years. So I'd like to start with a little story about Uttar Pradesh. It's quite tired. And we entered this marketplace. And when we entered the marketplace, a lady came running to me. And she said,
मुझे इन लोगों ने बर्बाद कर दिया है. These people have destroyed my life. So I said, who has destroyed your life? किसने आपकी जिंदगी बर्बाद की? पुलिस वालों ने. The police has destroyed my life. I said, क्यों? Why? She said, because they have put a 302 case on my husband. 302 का केस लगा दिया है. 302, for you who don't know, is a murder case in India. And so a policeman was standing next to me, and I asked, so I got suspicious, and I turned around and asked the lady, behan ji, kya aapke pati ne khoon kiya hai? Sister, has your husband actually murdered someone? And she says, haan, khoon to kiya hai. Yes, he has murdered someone. So I said, so then what are you saying to me? How can you be telling me to help you, your husband has murdered someone? And then she looks at me in Hindi, she says, to phir tum rajnetaon ka kya fayda? What are you politicians doing then? So this is the type of expectations that we have. She asked me two questions that day. She asked me what we politicians are doing. And the second question she asked me was what the politician was doing there. And these are the two questions I want to answer here. Why am I here? And what am I trying to achieve? I'm here today with you in Bahrain. But this time I'm here to tell you what you mean to your country, that you're important, to tell you that there is a serious problem at home, to tell you that you are a part of the solution, and that I am here to build a bridge between in the world and home. I represent the Congress Party of India, a party that was born to bring the people of India together, to bring people of all communities, all religions together. This has been our mission from the beginning. And this is why all of us are in politics, and this will be our mission till the end. The Congress's vision is one that builds bridges and is compassionate. It is a tried and tested vision that has fought for India in its toughest moments. Ours, more than any other vision, because of the struggle and because of the victory in India's liberation, is a vision that has strong roots in the NRI community. People forget this, but our greatest leaders, whether it is Mahatma Gandhi ji, whether it is Jawaharlal Nehru ji, whether it is Mr. Ambedkar, all of them were once NRIs. All of them were once what you are. And a little over 100 years ago, that great man, Mahatma Gandhi, returned to India from South Africa. He wasn't alone. With him stood a close-knit group of visionaries, each one a giant in his own right. And together, they inspired the world and generations beyond their own. They helped build an Indian vision. It was not a vision for one community, for one caste, for one state. It was a vision for the entire country. And it was a vision that was appreciated by every single person on the planet. The most important thing about any human being is that he knows who he is and where he comes from. Where do you come from? You come from those brave visionary men and women who delivered India its freedom. People who, like you, were open to the outside world. Like you, all of them had lived abroad and seen the shortcomings of their oppressors. They lived abroad and worked and studied and watched. And they returned to fight for the nation they loved. India today is free, but once again, it is under threat. There are two clear threats facing our country today. The first is our government's inability to provide jobs for our people. Our main competitor, China, produces 50,000 jobs every 24 hours. India currently produces 400 jobs in the same amount of time. It is an important figure, so I will put it another way. What China does in 2 days, takes India 1 year to do. These are not my figures. These are figures of the government of India. These are figures stated by a minister in our parliament. Job creation in India is at an 8-year low. New investments are the lowest they have been in 13 years. Bank credit growth has sunk to a 63-year low. To make matters worse, many in the Indian diaspora have lost hard-earned money because of arbitrary decisions like demonetization. They have landed a crippling blow to India's overall economic growth. The fact is that India can simply not afford this. We are the second most populous country in the world. Every day, 30,000 new youngsters come into India's job market. Not providing education and jobs to these youngsters is a recipe for disaster. The government's failure to create jobs is resulting in tremendous anger and unrest in India. The youth are asking a very simple question. What are we to do in our future? This anger is visible in the streets and is rising rapidly. The tragedy is that instead of focusing the attention of our people on what is critical, the removal of poverty, job creation, and the building of a world-class education system, we see instead a rise in the forces of hatred and division. Instead of accepting that we are struggling to create jobs, instead of uniting people together, all communities and religions, to face the challenge, the government is busy converting the fear being generated in our jobless youth into hatred between communities. Tragically, the conversation in our country today is not about jobs, healthcare, or education. Today, the only thing India talks about is what you are allowed to eat, who is allowed to protest, and what we can say, or rather what we cannot say. Activists and journalists are threatened. They are shot dead for expressing their views. People are killed because of their religious beliefs. Dalits are beaten into submission. Judges investigating sensitive cases die under mysterious circumstances. And through all this, the government has nothing to say. Friends, India has been taken off its path of progress. Indians at ideals. You, your openness, your skills, your talent, your tolerance, your patriotism is what India needs today. You have shown us and the world how you have built the countries you have journeyed to. You have lived with people of different nationalities, different religions, different philosophies, and you have done so both by learning from them and by teaching them about our great Indian traditions and heritage. India today has the largest diaspora of any country in the world. More than 16 million people of Indian origin live abroad. The countries of the Gulf region are among India's most important trading partners. The largest numbers of Indian expats live here. India is also the largest remittance receiving country in the world. You send almost $70 billion. That is 3.5% of India's GDP. You're responsible for creating massive wealth globally and for giving back more than three times your fair share to India each year. Here in the Gulf, NRI send back more than half of the remittances that India gets from around the world. Many of you and your ancestors came to these foreign lands with nothing but dreams. You came empty-handed. And out of those dreams, you have built entire nations. All of you in this room are proof that India can bridge any gap that is put before it. And no global vision for India can be built without you. It is impossible, let me state from this stage, that it is impossible to build a global vision for India in the 21st century without our brothers and sisters who live abroad. Together we must steer India back to its original strengths. We need to make India the centerpiece of ahimsa, of non-violence, back from violence between our people. And we cannot do that at home without our largest skill base on the planet, all you people in this room. I've not come here to tell you anything really. No. I've come here to ask for your help. I've come here to ask you for your skills, for your guidance, and for your understanding. We need you to help us fight these forces of anger and hatred. We need you just as we needed you and our ancestors needed you in 1947 to protect the idea of India that we so dearly love and cherish. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Sri Rahul Ji. Now, the next session will be moderated by Dr. Sam Petroda. It will be a small question and answer session.
I'm going to request for some brief questions. Mr. Rahul Gandhi has agreed to take some questions from the audience here. There are four microphones around. Raise your hand, identify yourself, be brief, don't give big comments and opinion, Be specific and keep quiet, please. Can we have first question? Microphone.
Can I stand? Thank you. Yes, my name is Jay Banerjee, and I'm the president of GoPio Toronto. We welcome you, and I'm glad to be here. So my question to you is, this being your first visit outside of India, when are you going to come to Canada so we can welcome you, receive you, and do the same for you, sir?
No, in fact, I was speaking to Sam in the car today, and Sam... I was speaking to Sam in the car, and that's exactly what we said, that one of the places we really need to go is Canada. So we are. Sam is organizing, and Milind is organizing a set of trips to different parts of the world. We're going to do one to Canada, we're going to do one to Singapore, and we're going to do another one to the Middle East. So we're looking forward to that. And we will be in Canada. We'll come and have a chat with you in Canada.
What it means is you have to work. Okay, let's be clear. Thank you, because a lot of work has gone into putting this together. Thank you. More microphones.
Hello, sir. Very nice to meet you, Rahul Ji. I am Badusha, represented by KMCC Bahrain, one of the largest global organization in the expatriate community. Sir, dear Rahul Ji, we have big hope in you. So my question is, what initiative you will take for to keep up our secularism alive?
You know, when politicians give signals, politician can give a very simple small signal and it sets a particular direction. So the starting point is what is inside your heart. That's where you begin. In Hindi, you say, niyat kya hai? Right? And I cannot see an India, I cannot even imagine an India, where all our people do not feel part of India. I cannot imagine it, I cannot conceptualize it. So the starting point is that you believe that everybody in India, regardless of where they come from, how much money they have, which religion they come from, which caste they belong to, which state they come from, what they eat, what they say. The starting point is you believe that they are all Indian. For me, every single Indian person, whether he's in India or he's in Bahrain or he's in any other part of the country, is our asset, is our strength, is our knowledge, is our capability, is our belief. So what will we do? We will make all Indian people feel that they are Indian. We will make all Indian people believe that there is a place for them in India. And we will make every single Indian person believe that he has a great future in India and in the rest of the world. That's the starting point. Once you walk that path, the magic will automatically happen. Today the problem is that the signaling is wrong. I said in my speech, there is violence against somebody, there is silence. Somebody is threatened, there is silence. There should not be silence. The government of India should make its position clear. So that is the difference between us. We cannot imagine an India that doesn't belong to all of us. Thank you.
Good evening, sir. Good evening,
next
sir.
Next microphone.
Good evening, sir.
Where are you?
Okay. My name is Robin. I'm from Dubai. And I'm from media.
Hindi mein bole?
Ha.
Bolte hain.
Main aapka sawal Hindi mein hi puchunga. Aur congratulations, first of all, for aapke Gujarat mein jo bhi seethe aayi hain. मैं मीडिया से हूं तो मेरा आई अप्रिशिएट यू मैं आपकी बात का मैं आपकी बातों का ध्यान रखता हूं कि जो आप बोलते हैं आप एक्सेप्ट करते हैं कांग्रेस की पुरानी गलतियों को दैट आई कांग्रेचुलेट यू फॉर दिस थिंग दैट इन कांग्रेस यू आर चेंजिंग द कल्चर और लेकिन मेरा पर्सनल ये एक बीइंग एन इंडियन जो बाहर रह के देखता है कि इंडियन पॉलिटिक्स में क्या हो रहा है मैं ये चाहता हूं एक गैप है रूलिंग पार्टी में और ऑपोजिशन में वो गैप मनमोहन सिंह ने डिमोनेटाइजेशन के बाद कहा था कि जीडीपी नीचे जाएगी 2% से 3% पे लेकिन सड़कों पे उस चीज को नहीं लाया गया वो विनोद दुआ जी भी कहते रहे वायर में कि वो एक साल जो हमने वेस्ट किया बिंग ए कांग्रेसी और बिंग एन ऑपोजिशन पार्टी वो एक साल आपको कहीं ना कहीं गुजरात में ज्यादा फायदा पहुंचा सकता था बिंग एन ऑब्जर्वेशन आई एम जस्ट टेलिंग दैट देयर इज अ गैप बिटवीन ऑपोजिशन एंड द रूलिंग पार्टी एंड यू हैव टू व्हाट्स योर विजन बिंग ए प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ कांग्रेस नाउ योर फर्स्ट विजिट आउटसाइड इंडिया एंड बीजेपी विल लाइक अदर पार्टी रूलिंग पार्टी विल टारगेट यू यू आर कॉपिंग द प्राइम मिनिस्टर यू आर गोइंग आउट What's how you will counter because it's in the social media already. How you will counter? What's your policy to counter one the social media what they are targeting on you and how will you bridge the gap between the ruling party and the opposition? Because in ground it's somewhere it's missing. It's for my personal wish that you bridge the gap.
Can you please be brief? Please, we have lots of questions.
यू नो हिंदी में बोलूं
जी बोलो
आपने कहा कि कांग्रेस पार्टी अपनी गलतियां एक्सेप्ट करती है और आपने यह भी कहा कि मैंने भी कांग्रेस पार्टी की गलतियां मानी मैं अपनी भी गलतियां मानता हूं सिर्फ कांग्रेस पार्टी की नहीं मैं इंसान हूं और हम सब गलतियां करते हैं जो आपने कहा कि गैप मीडिया में जरूर है मीडिया में प्रचार होता है थोड़ा वन साइडेड होता है यह तो आपने देखा होगा नोट किया होगा उसके कारण है मगर कांग्रेस पार्टी जमीन पर लड़ रही है गुजरात बीजेपी का गढ़ है और मैं आपको कहना चाहता हूं वहां पे बच के निकली है बीजेपी कांग्रेस पार्टी ने क्वेश्चन किया तो हम लड़ रहे हैं मगर हमारा फोकस मैं आपको सच बताऊं तो हिंदुस्तान को एक विजन देने का है जरूर हम बीजेपी से लड़ते हैं मगर हमारा काम अपने आप को इंप्रूव करने का है आपको एक नई कांग्रेस पार्टी देने का है और मैं इस बात में भरोसा रखता हूं कि अगर हमने आपको हिंदुस्तान को एक नई कांग्रेस पार्टी दे दी बीजेपी को लड़ाना कोई बड़ी बात नहीं हराना कोई बड़ी बात नहीं तो हमारा फोकस हमारे ऊपर है हमने गलतियां की मगर हमारे पास स्ट्रेंथ भी बहुत है आपने मनमोहन सिंह जी की बात की डिमोनेटाइजेशन के दिन उन्होंने आपको बता दिया कि भैया 2% नुकसान होने वाला है और वही 2% नुकसान हुआ तो कांग्रेस पार्टी में एक्सपीरियंस है युवा हैं और हम अपने आप को बदल के आपको एक नई चमकती हुई बेहतर कांग्रेस पार्टी देने जा रहे हैं
थैंक यू राहुल जी
आई नो देयर आर लॉट्स ऑफ क्वेश्चंस आई वुड लाइक टू गिव अ चांस टू लेडीज यू फिनिश एंड देन विल गो टू दिस लेडी देन दैट लेडी एंड देन दिस लेडी
वन रिक्वेस्ट है आप प्रधानमंत्री बनाएगा तो हम लोग को हिंदी वाला इधर मर जाएगा तो आप फ्री लेके जाना मनते अपना घर लोग के
क्या 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 क्या
आप नेक्स्ट प्राइम मिनिस्टर बनाएगा तो फर्स्ट ऑर्डर हमको चाहिए। ये साल में इंडियन वाले 241 मर गया, कभी प्रदेश में मर जाते इंडियन वाला का बॉडी फ्री आप इंडिया में पहुंचाने के लिए कोशिश करना मत।
लेट अस नॉट आस्क फॉर गवर्नमेंट टू डू समथिंग फॉर यू, लेट अस सी व्हाट वी कैन डू टू मेक बेटर इंडिया। आई थिंक वी हैव टेंडेंसी टू ऑलवेज से व्हाट डू आई गेट, इट इज टाइम टू गिव। आई यूज टू टेल धीरूभाई अंबानी दैट द बिगेस्ट चैलेंज इन इंडिया is that those who have lot to give want to take, those who want to give have nothing to give, so relax, we'll worry about that.
Yes,
this is not a question, just on a lighter note, I would just like to first of all a big welcome to Bahrain.
Thank you.
I am from Assam, and some many years back, you know, I came to Indira Gandhiji's house with my grandfather. And my grandfather is Mr. Mahendra Mohan Chaudhary. He was the governor of Punjab at that time. And Indiraji had just lost her elections, and so he had come to Chandigarh to see her to Delhi. And I went with him to your grandmom's house. And there was a big dog. You had dogs.
Yes, 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 yes.
And he came out, and I was so scared. I was a little girl. And then, you know, I got so scared when Indiraji called Rajiv Ji, your dad, and you came along with him, and that time maybe you were 6-7 years old, and that memory will never go. And I'm so happy that today you have taken up the reins of the party, and all the best wishes, and we would like to see more and more good things in the party. Thank you so much.
And nice to see you again.
Thank you.
Hold on. Let me.
Hello. Namaste, Rahul Ji.
Namaskar.
Don't waste time.
Sure. You are one of the potential of the India. My very simple question to you, what will be the top three actions which you would like to take given a chance that you get the power to do so? Three actions, not generic, reduce hatred, remove poverty, not three concrete actionable items. What you will be do from the first day of your, if you get a chance?
One is, as I mentioned in my speech, the central priority for India has to be the creation of jobs. We speak about GDP growth, but we do not speak about how many jobs are being created. So turning the focus of our country into the single purpose of creating jobs for youngsters, I believe that the way to create jobs is through small and medium industry. So supporting small and medium industry to create millions of jobs in India, that's number one. Number two, we have a great education system, but only the top layer of that education system is high quality. Sam Pitroda had done some work in the last government on transforming the Indian education system, making it a global system, making it a system that is open to the rest of the world. We have a plan. We're going to put that plan in operation. And the third point is developing a strategy for healthcare where India can take care of its healthcare needs and become a global hub for healthcare. Those would be our three priorities, and that's what we would act on.
Can we please move on.
Hello, Rahul Ji. I'm Swarnalata Amin.
Nice to meet you.
Sir, main Indira Gandhi se mili hoon. मैं छोटी थी, 8th स्टैंडर्ड में थी, तभी मैं उनके जीप पे चढ़ी थी।
अच्छा,
उन्होंने मुझे पकड़कर चढ़ाया था इंदौर में एयरपोर्ट रोड स्कूल की।
अच्छा,
वहां पे, और मुझे
वो खुली वाली जीप पे
हाँ। जीप पे सर, और मुझे तब से ये पता चला है इंदिरा जी को गरीब और अमीर में कोई फर्क नहीं है, मतलब उस दिन मैंने उनको, मुझे पता चला कि ये बहुत अच्छा इंसान है। ऐसा उनमें, उन्होंने जितना वो आपसे प्यार करते हैं उतना ही उन्होंने मुझसे प्यार किया। और मैं एक बहुत गरीब बच्ची थी, मैं सरकारी स्कूल में पढ़ी। ऐसा
बिल्कुल।
तो, ओके सर, मुझे ये पूछना, मैं पूछना है कि ये जो सोशल मीडिया एंड ये व्हाट्सएप के थ्रू
ये स्ट्रेटजी है, इसके पीछे पैसा है, इसके पीछे सपोर्ट है, तो ये झूठ चलेगा। बट झूठ के अंदर से सच्चाई भी दिखाई देती है। सो यू विल सी आप देखेंगी कि जितना भी झूठ बोला जाए, सच्चाई पावरफुल चीज होती है, वो निकल के आ जाती है। डायमंड इज डायमंड, वो दिख रहा है। तो यू डोंट नीड टू वरी अबाउट झूठ।
ओके सर, थैंक यू।
यू हैव टू डिसाइड हु यू आर गोइंग टू ट्रस्ट। इट्स अ ट्रस्ट।
गुड इवनिंग, हाउ आर यू?
फाइन, थैंक यू। थैंक यू राहुल सर जी।
टेल मी,
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आपने रिक्वेस्ट स्टेज में किया, हिंदी में बोलते हैं तो मेरा भी दिल बोलता है, हिंदी में बोल देता हूँ। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल मेरा नाम अतीक है और मेरे कजिन, मैं बैंगलोर से हूँ, कर्नाटका से। मेरे कजिन को आपने और सोनिया जी ने वाइस चेयरमैन गवर्नमेंट ऑफ कर्नाटका स्पोर्ट्स के वाइस चेयरमैन बनाए। आज सवाल मेरा यह है कि काफी सालों से कर्नाटका में कांग्रेस ही है, हम सिर्फ कांग्रेस ही चाहते हैं, और इसके लिए आप, इलेक्शन नजदीक है, उसके लिए कितना तैयार हैं आप?
तैयार हैं, हमारी वहां पे काफी अच्छी टीम है, हमारे चीफ मिनिस्टर सॉलिड नेता हैं, आप जानते हैं उनको, गरीबों के नेता हैं, तो हमारी तैयारी अच्छी है और वहां हम चुनाव जीतेंगे। थैंक यू
सर, एंड वेलकम टू बहरीन।
गुड इवनिंग
सर, माय नेम इज कैप्टन अरविंद शर्मा, आई एम एन एक्स आर्मी ऑफिसर फ्रॉम इंडिया। I am today accompanying senior most Parsi community member, Air Commodore Sikandar Malao. He is 83 years of age. He has come to listen to you. And his son, Commander Neville Malao. So the Army, Air Force and the Navy, all three are here to welcome you today.
Thank you.
That's one.
So should I come and say hello then?
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Please.
Sir,
there are too many people in line.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for the honor, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much. There are very few people who understand this aspect of the forces.
Sir, quickly. Can we quiet down a little bit? Please sit down.
Secondly, sir,
you can see it.
I have been brought up in Amethi as a child, where my father was the first and longest serving project manager of Hindustan Aeronautics Limited.
Okay.
He was the one who raised
it. Yes.
So my question, in brief, is that India is a country of large and huge cultural diversity. Accordingly, we have huge political diversity. We have lot many political parties, and there are lot many political ideologies. So, sir, aisi kya cheez hai highest echelons mein? अभी आजकल दे गेट स्वेड बाय, एज द लेडी सेड, सोशल मीडिया, दे आर नॉट एबल टू गो इन टू द डेप्थ ऑफ द बिहाइंड द सीन्स एक्टिविटी। सो इज द हाइएस्ट एशलॉन्स, इज देयर सम वर्किंग यू नो इन कॉमन विच इज विच कैन हेल्प द पॉपुलेशन डिसाइड एज टू विच पॉलिटिकल आइडियोलॉजी टू आइडेंटिफाई विद?
आई थिंक the Congress party, you would agree that in India's history the Congress party is the most tested ideology. So our ideology, when India needed it most, when India needed freedom, the ideology that worked for India was the Congress ideology. And what is the Congress ideology? It is bringing everybody together. It is not creating division. So we are very confident that is the way forward. As the gentleman said, we are not superhuman. We also make mistakes. And I would say that we made some mistakes. And I'll say it happily in front of you. So I think what we have to do is we have to present a new Congress party to you, a new vision to you, something that you can believe in, something that you already trust. And it is something that we are working on. And I'm confident that you will see dramatic change in the Congress party, and you will see leaders that you believe you can trust, that you believe can lead states and our country.
I would like to add that don't outsource your thinking.
Thank you, Rahulji. Thank you.
Hello.
Yeah. I am Mansoor Pallu, coming from Dammam, Saudi Arabia. My question is.
Hold on. Where are you?
My question is a question. We are living in this digital age. Everything getting updated in seconds. Even our mobile phones, everything getting updated. Indian politics is not getting updated. What is the updated version of visions?
You give us 6 months, we will update it.
Good.
Thank you.
Give us 6 months, we will update it.
Please wait on that side. Quick, just speak.
Yes, I am also Purvi Gandhi. So Gandhi meets Gandhi. Hello, you have cuter smile.
Thank you.
I want to ask you question which is not connected to politics.
Quick, yeah. Ask question, don't comment on other things.
Okay. You are living the life which millions are dreaming for it. Par kabhi aapne sapne mein aisa matlab ki chalo friends ke saath chill out kare, freely jaye, मतलब दिल मजे करे मूवी देखे तो ऐसा करने के लिए राहुल गांधी क्या करते हैं एक वो क्वेश्चन
मैं एक दिन मूवी देखने चला गया वो टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया वाले पीछे पड़ गए मेरे
एंड द सेकंड क्वेश्चन सर
नहीं बट आई नीड माय स्पेस टू थिंक आल्सो सो आई रीड क्वाइट अ लॉट आई एवरी नाउ एंड देन डू गो एंड वॉच मूवीज So I keep myself informed about things.
And no second question. Sir. Please. There are too many people. Please.
Thank you. You have cuted smile.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello.
Good evening.
Quick.
Good evening.
We have 5 more minutes. So
we'll come to you.
No more than 5 seconds to ask a question.
Good evening, Rahul.
He's very impatient, huh?
Looks like. Yeah, my name is Santosh Varghese. I work for Toshiba as a general manager for Middle East and Africa. Warm welcome to Bahrain. I'm based in Dubai. My question to you is, all government faces challenge in job creation globally. It's not very easy to create job. So my question to you is, what is Congress party, or that's our party, I'm also a sympathizer of Congress, strategy for self-employment, entrepreneurship? Because there is a massive shortage of skills in India. There is a culture of Me Too. There's no culture of innovation, which is there. There's a massive shortage.
I would question that idea.
So what is the strategy?
I don't agree that there is no innovation in India.
I'm talking of the mindset.
No, I think what I've seen in my travels, and I've traveled to thousands of villages, there is tremendous innovation in India every day, every place. The problem is that the people who are innovating are not getting the support they need. And the people who are getting the support are not really innovating that much. So it is a question of providing support to the innovators in India.
We had a National Innovation Council during Dr. Manmohan Singh's time. We had a skill development mission. So all these things have been in the works. Unfortunately, a lot of our friends don't really read enough, pardon me for saying it, and don't get into enough details on what's going on in India. Lot of good stuff is going on. So I would request you to just read about the skill development. It'll tell you where we are.
I agree, but we haven't come out globally. Anywhere.
Sorry, go on.
We haven't come out globally anywhere. We don't have, we just handful of Indian companies who are global companies, right? Just 9 unicorns in India compared to 53 unicorns in China or 95 in US.
So we have to decentralize. If you look at our banking system today, huge amount of support 15 big business people. There are millions of things, but they don't have access to the banking system. So if you want them to be successful, you need to open the door of the banking system to them. You need to go find them, you need to go support them, and you need to give them finance. Without finance, you're not going to be able to build a business. So these are the type of things that we would look into.
Okay, can we go there?
But India is, I think, the world's biggest innovator.
I fully agree.
Thank you.
सब साफ हो गया और उसके लिए आपको बहुत-बहुत मुबारकबाद. लेकिन सवाल मेरा ये है कि वो 2G का प्रोपेगेंडा करके गवर्नमेंट में आए, यूपी में उन्होंने झूठ बोला, वो यूपी में आए और गुजरात में आपने बेहतरीन काम किया और उसके लिए आपको ढेरों मुबारकबाद. लेकिन वो लास्ट में झूठ बोलते हैं और वो फिर आ जाते हैं, तो पूरे भारत में उन्होंने अपने झूठ से अपने आप को फैला लिया है. कांग्रेस की क्या तैयारी है 2019 में और आप क्या सोच, आपका क्या प्लान है कि इस झूठ के प्रोपेगेंडे को कैसे खत्म किया जाए? और दूसरा सवाल मेरा ये
झूठ
है,
झूठ को सच से ही खत्म किया जा सकता है?
नहीं राहुल जी, अभी आपने कहा कि हमारी ग्राउंड पे तैयारी चल रही है, क्या आपको नहीं लगता कि बीजेपी की जीत नहीं बल्कि आरएसएस की ग्राउंड की जीत है और उसकी वजह से बीजेपी जीतती है? तो कांग्रेस की क्या तैयारी है 2019 में?
आपने जो झूठ की बात बोली सही है, मगर आप एक बात याद रखिए कि बीजेपी 3 साल से सरकार में है, उससे पहले कांग्रेस पार्टी सरकार में थी. तो कांग्रेस पार्टी कोई मामूली चीज नहीं है, कांग्रेस पार्टी को लड़ना आता है. कांग्रेस पार्टी ने अंग्रेजों को हराया, कांग्रेस पार्टी ने हिंदुस्तान को बदलने का काम किया, पैरों पे खड़े करने का काम किया हिंदुस्तान की जनता के साथ मिलकर. तो ये कोई मामूली चीज नहीं है. और मैं आपको आश्वासन दे सकता हूं कि ये पार्टी जो है इसमें इतनी शक्ति है कि ये 2019 में उनको हरा के दिखा देगी.
क्विक 1 2 क्विक.
Molly Banerjee from Toronto, Canada. It's a real pleasure to meet you in person.
Thank you.
Your grandmother was a great leader. Your mom has been involved in politics. There are lots of women in India who are in powerful positions. But gender equity is still a big problem.
Yes.
In the country. So when you become the Prime Minister of the country, how do you intend to address this important problem?
There is a law that we've been trying to pass, we tried to pass when we were in government, and we are putting pressure on the government to pass it now, but we will certainly pass when we come to power, which is a law for reservation of women in Parliament House. Okay. That guarantees a certain number of seats to women in the political system. We already gave women place in the lower elected system, in the panchayat structure. But that would be a huge step forward for the empowerment of women. I do feel myself personally for pushing women ahead in politics. So I capable women and involve them in politics. So that is something.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
Hello. We have time for 3 questions. One quick, one. Quick.
Hello.
Hello.
Can we keep quiet for the next 5 minutes, please?
Welcome to Bahrain.
Thank you.
Very nice. ये सवाल है कि बहुत सारे भारतीय लोग, especially poor people, they live in countries, foreign Gulf, in the case of earning more money, they encounter a situation where they lose their job due to unknown reasons. net. So what are the rehabilitative measures that can be, you know, thinking of what disasters can happen in the future?
Okay. I mean, what is the type of support for them?
Yes.
I mean, I think a lot of that work can be done. Best solved by having a conversation with you, with the community here.
Right.
What exactly is required? I think you raised a point. Be sent home, and that's something that is very important to us, and we will try and ensure. But I think it is best and tell us the type of things that you think we need to do, and then we'll help you and we'll do them. Thank you.
Hello.
Hello, sir.
My name is Vinay Divan.
Namaskar.
Sanjay and Rajiv Bhatt. I have a quick question. How do you serious issue?
Selfie-based campaigns to promote the daughter in India, and being a journalist based in Bahrain who would love to move back to India but is always hesitant because of the various news that goes around, what initiatives suggest?
What news is worrying you?
All the rape incidents that have been popular recently, unfortunately, that have been going on, especially the Nirbhaya case. And all of that's been scaring my parents who are in the audience and don't think India is a country for me to go to. What do you suggest are the initiatives that should be taken up to truly empower the women, not just through selfies, but truly empower the women, wherein a woman can walk outside and be confident that she's safe in her own country?
Okay. I think a couple of things. One is, first of all, the Nirbhaya case was a tragic case. And there are cases like that. But the idea that India is completely unsafe and is the rape capital of the world, this is not true. India is actually still a very, very relatively safe place. And the problem... No, leave, relax. And the problem... There is a problem, but it is not as huge a problem as the media makes it out to be. There is still quite a lot of respect for women in India. I think the first step, as I said earlier, is bringing women into the political system, bringing role models so that people can see women in parliament, in Vidhan Sabhas, as chief ministers, so you can see that women are involved in the system. I myself run an organization in Uttar Pradesh where we do work linking women to banks. So giving women bank loans, helping them start small businesses. And that's a very, very powerful thing. So the idea of microfinance, the idea of self-help groups, this has been transformative in India. Millions and millions of women's lives have been changed because of this type of activity. So there are things that are being done. I would recommend that you come and see for yourself. And I would recommend that you don't worry about coming back to India. You come back and work in India.
One question, hold on, last.
Fisherman.
I know. Fisherman.
Do you understand Tamil? I'm from Kanyakumari. My name is Francis.
Vanakkam.
Vanakkam. First of all, I say thank you. You visited our area last month. Chinnathurai, Tutur, that area.
Yes.
Still our fisherman was missing. He's missing. Still. So, future you will be the Prime Minister. These kind of disaster happen. What is your fast rescue operation? Now our rescue operation is very slow. Lot of hundreds of people are still missing. My friends, my relatives, my neighbors. What is your suggestion for?
Well, what I said in Kanyakumari, and I'll repeat here, is that Fishermen and farmers have similar problems. And the Congress party is committed to creating a ministry for fishermen that will look after the problems of fishermen across the country, inland fishermen, coastal fishermen. There is a ministry for agriculture, there is a ministry that looks after farmers, but there is no similar ministry for fishermen. And I think large numbers of problems of fishermen can be tackled if we have a fisherman's ministry at the national level that pays attention to what is going on. So I think that is one of the big steps that we would take. Thank you.
Last question.
Brother Rahul Ji, welcome to Bahrain.
Thank you.
I am the granddaughter of a freedom fighter and I have worked with a lot of Nehru Yuvakendra projects back in India. What I would like to request you in front of NRI forum, we have overseas ministry and we have a separate cabinet
you
minister.
You had overseas this. Ministry.
We have.
You had.
Okay. No? What, apart from that, okay, apart from that, what I would like to request you on behalf of the NRI community, we need separate ministership for the NRI community and we request you to assure you that there has to be representation should be from the NRI communities.
Yes.
Because a lot of intellectuals are outside India. So their brain power should not go wasted. So please think of or please okay. give assurance. Then only the problems of the NRI workers, problems of NRI communities will be addressed properly and the bonding between India and overseas Indians will be more.
Here.
Apart from overseas.
Here, ministry. Can you hear me out? There was a ministry for NRI during Dr. Manmohan Singh's time. That ministry had top NRIs, 20 advisors. I was one of those. Amritya Sen was another one. There were all kinds of people from all walks of life. Doctors, England, Africa. We did meet regularly, provide suggestions. BJP, for whatever reason, closed the ministry. Now it is part of Ministry of External Affairs. I can assure you, when we come back to power, we will have that ministry again.
But I think I want to just say, I want to say two words. You know, I alluded to this in my speech. Ministry is an important thing. But I think I want to build the systems in the Congress party that will allow NRIs to guide us when we think about a vision for India. I want to involve you in the process of developing our country. I want you to feel that even though you live outside India, you are fully involved with the future and the growth of India. So that would be my thinking. I would like to go further than a ministry. I would like to have some of your NRI leaders involved in the Congress party back home, advising us, guiding us, and taking us forward.
Okay, can we close it? Should we close it?
Yeah.
It's 7:30. Yeah. Look, excuse me. Hold on. Can I? We need next 3 hours minimum to answer questions. We don't have 3 hours. We were supposed to leave for dinner with the minister, Deputy Prime Minister, I believe, at 7:30. We are already late. My apology. I wish everyone has one question and there are 500 people. Everyone has only one question. I tell you what happens. When I go with him, people call me and say, sir, I need just half an hour with Rahul ji in a day. But there are 500 people who call me every day. So it's just not possible. We should be happy with what we accomplished. I want to thank you all for great participation. I want to thank Rahul Gandhi. And I tell you, we look forward to having more conversations with you.
And I'd like to conclude by saying I had a very nice time.
Yep.
I had a great time. Thank you very much. And I look forward to coming back here again and having a similar conversation again. Thank you. Good night.
Great.
I now call upon Mr. Neeraj Bakshi, the outgoing Gopio president, to felicitate the new Gopio team.
Rahul ji, Shashi ji, Sam ji, distinguished guests, my Gopio colleagues, and all of you. Nothing is more eternal than change. And the world of business is changing again. From internet global connections to cognitive intelligent connections. These cognitive intelligent interactions will change and will become the biggest industry of the 21st century. Our job is at Gopio is to energize and evangelize this and other messages that are all around us. Just as our engineers were the transformation agents, the future belongs to the knowledge agents of tomorrow. And that's the reason why we have launched the Gopio International Chamber of Commerce. Friends, can we have silence? Can we have silence? If you want to move, move slowly, move out, but do not talk. In these last 2 years at Gopio, we have had 6 international conventions, we have had growth of chapters, and we have had growth of membership all around. Join us in this journey, all of you, together. We will continue to make great contributions, not only to our countries of domicile, but to India. Our unified new team leadership under President Sunny Kulathakal will make even greater progress. Sunny, I wish you great success. We at Gopio would like to thank you, Rahulji, Shashi ji, and all of you for sparing your valuable time and to be with us. My heartiest gratitude and thanks to all of you, to all our delegates, and to the King of the Kingdom of Bahrain, the Prime Minister, the Crown Prince, the government, and all of the people of this very beautiful country for all their hospitality and their warm welcome. Thank you for being at the convention. Thank you for supporting Gopio. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Neeraj Bakshi, the outgoing president of Gopio. We now have a special memento, and may I request the presence of Sheikh Khalifa bin Daij, please, on the stage.
Can you request Rahulji and Samji to please?
Presented with profound gratitude to His Excellency Sheikh Khalifa bin Daij Al Khalifa, President of the Court of His Highness the Crown Prince, by Sri Rahul Gandhi. And likewise, we would like to have the honor.